Dream that was an Eskimo. Frozen wind began to blow. Under my boots and around my toes. Frost had bit the ground below. Was 100 degrees below zero. And my mama cried. And my mama cried. Don't be a naughty Eskimo. Save your money, don't go to the show. Right about that time, people, a fur trapper who was strictly from commercial had the unmitigated audacity to jump up from behind my igloo. He started it with on my favorite baby seal with a lead-filled snowshoe. I said, with a lead-filled with a lead-filled snowshoe. He said, peek-a-boo, with a lead-filled with a lead-filled snowshoe. He said, peek-a-boo. He went right upside the head of my favorite baby seal. He went whack with a little snowshoe. Hit him on the nose and he hit him on the finley. That got me just about as evil as an Eskimo boy can be. So I bent down and I reached down and I scooped down and I gathered up a generous mittful full of the deadly. The deadly yellow snow from right there where the huskies go. Whereupon I proceeded to take that mitten full of the deadly yellow snow crystals and rub it all into his beady little eyes with a vigorous circular motion hitherto unknown to the people in this area. But this will take the place of the mud shark in your mythology. Here it goes now, the circular motion. Rub it. In a fit of anger, I pounced, and I pounced again. Great googly moogly. I injured the fur trapper. Well, he was very upset, as you can understand.
And rightly so, because the deadly yellow snow crystals had deprived him of his sight.
And he stood up, and he looked around, and he said,
I can't see. I can't see. See,
Who took the ball to snow cone and stuffed it in my right eye? He took a dog to snow cone and stuffed it in my other eye. And the husky wee wee, I mean the doggy wee wee, is blind to me. And I can't see temporarily. Well, the fur trapper stood in there
with his arms outstretched across the frozen white wasteland, trying to figure out what he's going to do about his afflicted eyes. And it was at that precise moment that he remembered an ancient Eskimo legend wherein it is written, on whatever it is that they write it on up there, that if anything bad ever happens to your eyes, as a result of some sort of conflict with anyone named Nanook, the only way you can get it fixed up is to go trudging across the tundra, mile after mile, trudging across the tundra, right down to the parish of St. Alphonso. At St. Alphonso's Pancake Breakfast, where I stole the margarine, and wheedled on the bingo cards and knew a late latrine. I saw a handsome parish lady, make her entrance like a queen. Well, she was totally chill, and her old man was a marine. As she abused the sausage patty, I said, why don't you treat me mean? At St. Alfonso's Pancake Breakfast, where I stole the margarine.
Good morning, your highness. Good morning, Your Highness.